they learn every week on the game called College Madhouse. Players which challenging the Bears of Brown University and the Tigers of Princeton University. And now, here's the dean of College Madhouse, Drew.
Finest colleges and universities compete in a battle of both brains and brawn, featuring some fairly outrageous and interesting physical stunts, as well as a lot of challenging questions. At the end of the game, the winning team gets to run to the college madhouse, located right back there, win some prizes for themselves, also some scholarship money for their individual schools. So it's all for a good cause. Right now, here to introduce today's team, the oh-so-subtle Bo Weaver.
First direct from Providence, Rhode Island, here comes the team from Brown University.
Hi, my name is Greg Kuroda. I'm a sophomore economics major at Brown University. I'm the captain today, and I just like to say hi to all my justified brothers throughout the Brown.
Mary Barber, and I'm a bio major at Brown University, and I want to say hi, Mom, and hi, TA3.
Hi, my name is Claudia Santurio. I'm a poli sci major at Brown University. I'd like to say hi to my mom, my dad, and JTB&B.
Hi, my name's Alex Bolin. I'm a senior at Brown, and I'm majoring in Russian studies.
And what about the Brown Bears competition here today, though?
Next, from Princeton, New Jersey, we have Brown Talk's rival. Here comes the mighty Tigers from Princeton University.
Hi, I'm Kevin Friedman. I'm team captain. I'm a junior majoring in bodybuilding. And I like to say Princeton Lightweight Football League champs, number one.
I'm Natalie Mack. I'm a junior, and I'm majoring in art history. I'm Ellie Kavanaugh. I'm a junior history major. I want to say hello to the Princeton Women's Track and Rugby team.
Hi there. I'm Michael Goldberg. I'm a sophomore robotics major. I'd like to say hi to the Dog Pound in Cleveland, Ohio, and all my friends at Fine Library. Go Princeton!
That is Donna Wilson and Richard McGregor. Through the first part of the game, our teams earned points, of course, by, as we said, competing in those physical stunts and answering some questions. We're going to get started right now. We need two players from each team right over here. Okay, we are here at the College Madhouse National Geyser Park. Geysers are going to start splooging, girls. You're going to catch as much water as you possibly can in your mouth. Head up to one of these buckets, these tubes in front of you here, and you will release your geyser water into the tube. And the guys, while the girls are doing that, are going to be doing the same thing. Let's get this thing started. Set the clock. Ready. Set. Go. See how he did. I think that Brown did a little bit better on this particular thing. Clearly about twice as much. Brown, you guys win the stunt. We're going to go over here and give you some points. So Brown picked up 25 there. I'm very proud of him, Terry. I'm sure you are. That liquid in the stunt was a little cold. Which of these liquids is found inside most any thermometer? Turpentine. Yeah, for instance.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what we're looking for. So 25. Now that's the end of our first part of our sun round. The girls are going to be shedding off their clothes for a little pool action in just a moment. You want to see this? Stay with us. My ladies are dressed up in these very stylish skirts, poly cotton blend down here, shirts, bras, wigs, looking very smiley. When I say go, both of you are going to jump into the pool. girls, you're going to take off your skirt, put it on your partner, and help him put on the bra, the shirt, the wig, the whole nine yards. Guys, when you're dressed, you're going to race to this end of the pool, come out of the pool completely dressed, and we'll give you 25 points all for that little scenario. You also have to take the fashion risk here. Go ahead and get in place right now. No. Okay, so we're all set. Ready, set, go! Actually, it was very close. I shouldn't say it wasn't close. I should say it was very close. You guys both had a good one, but it looks like the Brown Bears were out a little bit. We're going to give you the shot. Let's go down and give you the points right now. Okay, so the Brown Bears pick up another 25 points there. Okay, Kevin, you can tie it up here, though. The shirts in that last stunt were buttonless, a popular cloth used in making button-down shirts. Has the same name as which of these universities? Harvard, Oxford, or Baltimore? Yeah, Oxford. Brown, you are absolutely right for 25 points. So pick up another 25. 75 Brown, 25 for Princeton. Let's go over to the next stop. We need all the players right over here. Well, we've all heard of the game, King of the Hill. Okay, and here's how we play it. The first player in line, when I say go, is going to run over here, grab this lovely rope hanging right here. You're going to climb to the top of the hill. As soon as you get there, grab one of those nice, incredible Imperial Margin crowns on the top. Crown yourself, slide down to the bottom, tag a teammate. Your teammates can do the same thing. The first team to crown all four players picks up 25 points. Now, the only problem is we've had a little rain lately. Things have gotten a little messy over here. Kev, come here for a second. Rub your hand right through that. What do you think? Look at that. See that? We have had a little... Thank you. We've had a little mudslide here in Southern California, so things are going to get a little messy. You got a minute to do this. We're all set. Get in place right now and set the clock. Ready, set, go! You guys, obviously, look at this. Lovely. They went to the top of the point. All for 25 points. You can take your crown off anytime, Natalie. Okay, next question. Here we go, folks. In that stunt, your teammates crown themselves. For centuries, most British royalty has been crowned in which of these places of worship? St. Peter's in Rome, the East End Synagogue, or Westminster Abbey? Yes. That's right, Princeton. Good job. That is the Brown Bears, 75. Princeton, 75. It's time for the college madhouse final. In just a moment, stay with us.
Well, it's time for finals on the madhouse. Back to you, Greg.
Okay, this is it. Today's college madhouse finals. A minute and 30 seconds of lightning action. It's some pretty challenging questions at stake. A crack at all the cash and prizes in the college madhouse right back here. Here's how it works. The teams are going to line up and face each other. In fact, why don't we go ahead and do that? Princeton and Brown. Guys, you're in front there. First players, I'm going to ask you a question. Very nice.
Thanks, Greg.
You're going to race to hit the signal. Come up with the right answer, we'll give you 25 points, all right? Plus, you get the opportunity, as you know, to nail your opponent with a pie. What is this today? What do you got there? Chocolate.
Some sort of
a chocolate delight. When I say next, you two are going to step to the back of the line. The next two are going to step in and take your place. We'll continue on like that for a minute and 30 seconds. Then we're going to find out who is going to the college madhouse based on the score. Right now, it's 75-75, so obviously at 25 points a game, it is anybody's game. The category right now, ancient history. Questions about the 1950s and 60s. Set the clock, please. Here we go. When this zany redhead premiered her first sitcom in 19... Princeton.
Lucy.
Yes.
Lucille Ball.
Boom. To the back of the line. For 25, Jimi Hendrix, Bob Dylan, and many others performed at a legendary rock music. Yes, Princeton.
Woodstock.
Yes, for 25 points. Naylor. Next up here. In front of what Washington, D.C. landmark did Martin Luther King give his immortal I Have a Dream speech? Princeton.
Washington, Miami.
No, Brown. No, to the back of the line, the Lincoln Memorial is what we're looking for. This long-running TV dance show hosted by Dick Clark. Yes, Brown. Yes, for 25. Back in 1953, Walt Disney created a TV series starring Annette Funicello. Yes, Princeton.
The Musketeers.
No, I'm going to finish the question. In 53, Walt Disney created a TV series starring Annette Funicello and led by Minnie's boyfriend, named the children's TV show. Yes, that's right, right there for 25 points. Next up, in the 60s, musician who led the way in pulp folk music as partner of Art Garfunkel. Brown.
Simon. Paul Simon.
That's right, for 25 points. Next up, in the late 60s, champion heavyweight boxer Cassius Clay took a Muslim name. What was this name? Brown.
Muhammad Ali.
Yes, for 25. Next up, formerly a World War II general nicknamed Ike. Name the man. Yes, Princeton.
Eisenhower.
Yes, that's right, for 25 points. Next up, in 1962, what country was the focus of a dispute known as the Missile Crisis? Yes, Princeton.
Cuba.
Yes, for 25 points. Next up, in the late 60s, that's it. One last question to both of you players in line. Pay attention because we have one special rule here. If you buzz in first and your answer is incorrect, your opponent automatically wins. So you want to make sure that you know the answer. You all ready? Got the weapons down because I know. The senator's death by assassination in 1969 echoed his brother's JFK. Princeton. That's right!
Contestants with the British Knights, get off on the right foot, get off in BK's British Knights athletic footwear for guys, gals, and kids too. British Knights, the right move for you. And this assorted merchandise, P.S. Catano jeans, proportionally sized to fit the short, regular, and long-listed women and misses and women's sizes. Catano, the spirit of family.
Here, thank you to this young lady. Yeah. Back there. Hold it off. This is our last question. As a result, you guys are going into the college madhouse. Chance for $1,000 for your scholarship fund. Also, some great prizes for you, which Bo's going to tell you about right now.
Rush into the madhouse by racing around the pool and into the Zapatheria, where one of your opponents is waiting to give you cash and zap you with a face full of whipped cream. Next, climb up to the rocket, then try to get past the roommate from hell and grab the tag for his Factor 6 or her Factor 5 water ski, featuring quality fiberglass construction for long wear with bindings that are designed for easy adjustment, comfort, and durability, furnished by Connelly Skis. Plus Emerson's 40 memory telephone, an integrated 10 memory telephone with featureless remote answering machine, a fine product furnished by Emerson. Next, grab cash up in the human stew pot. Then, head straight to the flagpole and slide down to the lower deck. Somewhere on the paddle wheel, you'll find a tag for these bikes. Columbia's made in the USA, Mount Air, here's your 10-speed bicycle. Features sleek styling designed to handle any ride from city street to country hill in comfortable upright fashion, furnished by Columbia. And Ray-Ban precious metal sunglasses. They feature rare metals in 24-karat gold frames in gray, black, or white with changeable lenses. Paul Shalom certifies each is authentic limited edition Ray-Ban sunglasses. Or you could raid the frames for hidden cash. Then jump up to Fraternity Row and climb through the windows to find a cash tag. Next, race up to the Dean of Students, pull out his tongue and grab the tag to win dual control. Walk on the wild side of fashion with a picture-perfect woolen leather crested jacket furnished by dual control. And this luggage, Ricardo Beverly Hills Rodeo Drive 2 Collection. Fully lined, lightweight, bright and cheerful luggage, high-density nylon construction weekend or round-the-world trip. Furnished by Ricardo Beverly Hills. All these prizes for you, plus cash tags on Hurricane Alley, on Treasure Island, and tumbling in the campus grill. That's cash totaling $1,000 for your college scholarship fund, all in today's Madhouse.
First of all, who is going first into the madhouse?
Mad Kevbo here.
Yep. When I say go, you're going to rip into the madhouse back here, grab all the prize and cash tags as you can. But after 30 seconds, you're going to hear this sound. And that means you got to stop, and then player number two then is going to have his 30 seconds to run in there, capture all the prize tags so he can get his hands on. We'll keep on like that till all four of you have had your chance in there. And if all four of you clean house, that means get all 13 tags in there. We are going to send you on this vacation.
We'll be flying you to Bermuda. Each of you will spend an ultimate spring break vacation in sunny Bermuda. Redmond Sport will be your host for 3 nights and 4 days on an exciting Bermuda College vacation. A premier college getaway furnished by Redmond Sport and Travel. Plus, you'll enjoy Bermuda's college week. Free party cruises, beach barbecues, and much more while staying in the center of Bermuda's college week's activities at the beautiful Mermaid Beach Hotel.
Seconds on the clock, we'll go ahead and set the clock counter for 30 seconds. You all set there, Kevin?
When I start.
Ready, and go!
madhouse. The Temple Owls are out to outsmart the Wildcats of Villanova. And ladies, have we got a hot fudge Sunday for you. Of course, you guys are going to want to find out what these babes are doing behind bars. But watch out, because when pillows start to fly, things really get wet. Unbelievable! Temple takes on Villanova on TV's wildest show, College Madhouse.
That is next week on College Madhouse. Until next time, I'm Greg Canaro. I'm with Donna Richard. We will see you here.
Accommodations furnished by the Beverly.